Hi everyone, this is Nathan Funk, Technical Product Manager here at LMI Technologies. In this video, I want to give you a little introduction to expanded multi-sensor support. The Gocator has long supported pairing two sensors together, but now with the 4.6 release, we allow you to pair more than two sensors together all in one system. And the benefit here is that we allow you to merge all the data together within the Gocator and thus cover wider fields of view with very high resolution, something that you couldn't accomplish with just a single or two sensors. Now you have the ability of going even wider with more and more sensors. So in this video, I will show you how easy it is to add sensors to a system, align the sensors with a calibration bar, and then scan a large part with the great detail. I want to scan this automotive part, so I need to have a high resolution sensor to get all the detail that I want, but I need to cover the full part. I'm using three 2330 sensors with approximately 50 microns X resolution, and I mount them side by side to get the full coverage of the part. The second step is to add sensors to the system. And that's what I'm going to show you here in the interface. So we're looking at the interface for the main sensor right now, and I've got my two other sensors in the system that I'm going to add in. All I have to do is go to the sensor system panel, click the plus button here on buddying, and it's connecting right now. It's connected the first buddy, and I'm going to add another one, and it's also connected, so they're all hooked up together, and I can now lay them out, and that specifies where they are with respect to each other. So I go into the layout panel here, that's new, and I can position sensors by assigning their location on a grid. So for example, if I had one of them below the other two, I could just put one down here. I can add more columns if I had more sensors, remove columns. And my layout is actually similar to what it defaulted to. I just have three sensors side by side, so I'm going to put this one back here, and I'm going to say that it's also reversed. So now to perform the alignment, which is the next step, all I have to do is go into the scan page. I've already got encoder set up as my input for triggering, and I then go into alignment. I'm going to clear the alignment that's in here right now. So all I have to do now is position the bar on the conveyor. Then I click the align button here. And now my sensors are aligned. So I can see the results of the alignment just by going into the sensor panel here and then opening the transformations. So to finally scan, I'm going to go into surface mode. Then I set up my encoder spacing at 0.2. That looks good. I can check my surface generation. It's set to continuous. And then part detection, I'm going to set so that everything above the conveyor, 1 millimeter above the conveyor, is included in my part. All I have to do now is start scanning. And I'm going to start the conveyor with the part underneath. And there we go, I've got a result from my scan. As you can imagine, setting up more sensors isn't much more difficult. You just add them to the system, assign their positions on the grid, and perform an alignment. For large systems, you can also add the Gocator accelerator on a PC to collect and combine data from all sensors with practically no memory limitations. Thanks for watching.